Hey guys, it's Allyssa LaScala here from Fit With Bliss, and I had a story that I wanted to share with you guys tonight, and I'd love to get your feedback on it, because when I heard it, I wasn't too happy with what this doctor said. So I'm just going to start off by saying this does involve the little yellow pill, and I need to make a disclaimer from the start that I do not say that it cures, treats, prevents any disease. However, the way that this was presented to me makes me really question the integrity of some doctors, okay? So just so you guys understand where I'm coming from, today I was approached by the daughter of one of my current customers that has been on the little yellow pill forever. Hey, Amanda, thanks for joining. Hey, Miguel. So she reached out and she said, you know, my mom's been on the little yellow pill for months now, and she went to her doctor and her triglycerides had come down when she was getting her blood drawn and getting different tests done. Her cholesterol had come down, but she has been on Synthroid, which is a thyroid medication, for those of you who don't know, for someone that has an inadequate thyroid or a very low thyroid. Hey, John, thanks for joining. So they give it to somebody to be able to try and, you know, supplement for the thyroid hormones that they don't have, okay? So when she got her last test for thyroid, her level was at 1 for her one thyroid hormone. And when she went back this time, like I said, her cholesterol had gone down, her triglycerides had gone down, but her thyroid was up to 11. And so this woman's daughter reached out to me and said, you know, I just want to confirm, like, is the little yellow pill going to mess with any type of medication? Because her doctor wants to take her off of it, but my mom doesn't want to come off of it. She's feeling great. And so, you know, this isn't the first time it was presented to me like this, because actually my husband, Mike, he is type 1 diabetic. He was on high blood pressure medication. He was on thyroid medication, 76 units of insulin a day as a type 1 diabetic. And so when he started taking the little yellow pill, transitions started happening as well. But she said to me, she was like, she wants to keep taking it. Like, you know, what should I tell her? And so here was what I do want to tell you guys, is that the little yellow pill reduces the stress in your body by 40% in 30 days. And so it's not a miracle pill, guys, but it activates a miracle body. The way that you were created, that God created you, that whatever your higher power is created you, it was meant to function in this miraculous way. But when we have, you know, 40% of the stress on our body that is taken off, it's incredible how your body starts to heal itself. Now, I am not saying anyone that starts to take the little yellow pill is, oh, you're going to come off of this medication, come off of that medication. But what I am saying is a lot of people, a lot of individuals who do start taking the little yellow pill may not need as much medication when you're taking the stress off your body, taking inflammation off, and it utilizes medications more efficiently, okay? So what happened, think about this. Her thyroid started at 1. And then it went up to 11. And so when her doctor saw this, instead of saying, hey, you know what? You don't need as much of this thyroid medication. I think we should cut back your Synthroid and test your levels again in a couple of weeks and see how you feel and see if your levels go back down to where we're looking at them, you know, where we want them to be. But instead of saying, hey, let's just try cutting down the drug dose, it's, hey, let's throw away this herbal blend that's reducing the stress in your body. And so I struggle with that. I struggle with that a lot. And I praise God. I thank the Lord when Mike ended up going to his endocrinologist that he was so open to being like, wow, we can take you off your blood pressure medication, or you're not used, you don't need it anymore. Or wow, we need to cut your insulin down. You don't need as much. I am so glad that even though he is like a medical doctor and he's a, you know, a world-renowned endocrinologist, that he still was open to saying, hey, you know, whatever you're doing, continue doing it. It wasn't, hey, get off of this so we can keep you on the same level medications. But guys, what I want to point out to you and what I want you guys to start thinking about, no matter whether you're on the little yellow pill or not, but as you start making changes, exactly, Amanda, old school medical, but as you start making changes in your life, guys, as you start working out, as you start, you know, eating healthier, as you start doing more things in the holistic health realm, I want you to think about this, because if you're on cholesterol medication, if you're on blood pressure medication, if you're on multiple different types of medications, like type 2 diabetes, even for people that are like pre-diabetic and you're on metformin or things like that, I want you to think about this, is that if your doctor is against you doing something that's all natural, whether it's nutrition, whether it's supplementation, to be able to give you a better quality of health, and is not even presenting or conversing with you about cutting back on a drug, you may want to think about the integrity of that doctor. Now, by all means, like, guys, I am not saying that all doctors are morally corrupt. Like, I have a great MD. In fact, I'm seeing him tomorrow. I see him every 6 months. That he's a holistic MD. He looks at the prescription aspect because he believes there are, you know, there's necessary times for that. But he also looks at the holistic aspect and he figures out how to blend them. It's very integrative medicine. So if I were her, if I was this customer, what I'd be saying to this doctor is, hey, like, I really feel great on this supplement. So is there any way we can talk about maybe cutting down my synthroid a little bit to see if we get my numbers to where you want them to be? Maybe I don't need as much of that medication anymore. Or if you're somebody on blood pressure medication and all of a sudden your blood pressure is going too low, maybe say, hey, can we cut this back a little bit? I mean, it's a thought that naturally occurs in my mind, but you guys have to remember when doctors, most, you know, MDs are going to school, unfortunately, guys, how we're taught is it's symptom and drug. It's depression and Zoloft. It's, you know, type 2 diabetes and metformin. You know, it's that type of thing. And it's anxiety and then, you know, Ativan or whatever else is out there. And so what I want you guys to just remember is that, no, not every doctor is morally corrupt, but you have to remember if you're feeling better, if you're functioning better, and you need less pharmaceuticals, less drugs, or even come off of them and don't need to see them as often, how do they get paid? What are they losing? How are they supporting their family? And so I really, really value the doctors that are totally about doing what is best for the client, and they are out there. So if you feel like you have somebody that isn't really open to the holistic side, that doesn't even, you know, want to take the time to talk to you about nutrition or the proper, like, vitamins, supplements, anything out there other than really, you know, like, symptom and drug, guys, there are plenty of doctors out there that you can find somebody that does believe what you believe. Don't think that they're not out there. And a lot of them are still covered by insurance. You just have to really see what the integrity and the morals are behind people. Hey, Christina, thanks for joining and thank you for sharing this. I think it's extremely important because you have to remember, guys, they're getting paid by the visit that you come in and the drugs and the scripts that they write. And so, you know, some just, you don't know what you don't know, so they're not aware of it. Some are ignorance is bliss, and, you know, we don't learn as much about nutrition, or I wasn't taught that in school, so, hey, all I'm taught is symptom drug, and I go to seminars, and it's symptom drug, and that's easiest. And guys, if they're trying to abide by the law, and they don't want to get sued, a lot of people, a lot of doctors are hesitant to even tell you to do anything other than take a drug, because if something else happens, God forbid you take an all-natural herbal supplement that reduces your stress, like anything that could really get in the way of the drug working the way that they think it's supposed to work, they're not going to agree with it, and they feel like, you know, it's, everyone is sue happy these days, so they want to make sure that they're covering their asses, which I understand. But at the same time, the long-term effects of all these drugs, guys, I mean, we know. And so I'm so glad that people are finding Carrie. I know that you say you love your endocrinologist and she works with you, you know, trying to get you off of a handful of medications. That is awesome. I absolutely love that. But it just breaks my heart when I hear people say, you know, they go and take the little yellow pill to their doctor and they wouldn't even really look at it, or they see it and they're like, you know, no, and it's all natural, but, you know, they see it and it's something that, hey, I never know if this could have a side effect, so I'm not even going to say that it works because it's easier for them. They only have so much time to sit there in that office and talk with you, and so they have to get to their next patient. They don't have time to go home and look at the 23 peer-reviewed studies. Maybe they do and they just don't want to, or they're not going and looking at how, you know, at abcyellowpill.com to look and see how it literally is proven to reduce the stress in your blood by lowering your T-bars. Like, nobody wants to look at that. And so my feedback to you, my story to you guys is just to make sure that you feel right about what you're doing. If you feel it in your gut that you're like, man, I'm feeling better and maybe I don't need as much of this medication, you can absolutely find a doctor. And if you're in my area, if you're near Reading, Pennsylvania, or if you're near Collegeville, King of Prussia, I can point you to several that have, you know, incredible morals that will be able to point you in the direction of not feeling like you need to be reliant on certain medications. I mean, I know there are a bunch of health professionals in, you know, the Life Vantage company with the little yellow pill that, you know, they were hated on for a while because by other people that were in their practice, you know, cardiologists, nurse practitioners, other MDs, because they were passionate about an all-natural herbal supplement, but people are so focused on symptom and drug that anything that is taking business away from that is really frowned upon, but I love them and I look at them as like, you, just such a blessing that they're willing to stand out on what they believe in and what is best. Cause guys, we went from wellness to then like sick care. And now, you know, we're starting to try and transition back to wellness, and it's frowned upon when people are starting to reach out and try and do stuff holistic and natural, but it's okay. You should be able to do that. And if you don't have an MD that is for that, find one who does resonate with you, who feels like, you know, yeah, it's okay to come off of a drug, to be here or try and cut back a little bit, to be able to get your body to function the way it's supposed to. Guys, you know, you realize that like we're not meant to be on medications. And now it's earlier and earlier, people that are in their teens and 20s and 30s relying on drugs. We shouldn't need to do that. So if you can find an all natural way to do that, then do that. And I'm seeing so many, oh my God, I'm so blessed to know all of you guys. Thank you guys so much for all commenting, saying how much you love the either the little yellow pill or just that you love having you know, a doctor that looks at the holistic aspects. So much love to you guys. If you have any comments, because I'm sure I have people on both ends of the spectrum right now, I'm open to it. If you're someone that agrees with me or doesn't agree with me, feel free to give me your opinion. Just, you know, announcing once again that I'm not saying that all, you know, doctors are morally corrupt. However, I am saying that sometimes, you know, ignorance is not bliss, and we really do need to make sure that we are being just as faithful and feeling just as passionate about how we're taking care of our bodies as much as we put our trust in someone else's hands. So love you guys, and I will see you later. Have a good night.